Hello friends, this is Lekha Toraskar and welcome to my kitchen. The name of our today's recipe is Anda Masala. Before we begin, let us have a look at the ingredients. I am going to roast a few ingredients. So for that purpose, I have heated up some oil. I am adding cumin seeds. These are coriander seeds. This is flattened rice or poha. Rice. Black peppercorns, dry red chilies, I'm going to roast this. To this I am adding some tur dal. This is pressure cooked for 3 whistles. Some chopped onions, chopped tomatoes, so this is going to be a very different gravy. Once the tomatoes and the onions become soft and cook well, I'm going to add grated coconut. This is dry grated coconut. Always add the dry grated coconut at the end once the other ingredients are cooked so that it doesn't burn, because this dried coconut burns easily. So always add it at the end. I'm going to now saute it for just about 2 minutes and then put off the gas. So after 2 minutes, I'm putting off the gas and I'll allow this mixture to cool down. Once this mixture cools down, I have added it to the mixer jar, adding some water. This is around half a cup of water. So I'll blend this into a fine paste. If required, I'll add some more water later. So I have blended this into a fine paste and I have added almost 2 cups of water while blending. I have heated some oil over here. I have these slit green chilies. I'm going to just roast them gently. Once roasted from both the sides, I'm going to remove it from the pan. Adding some more oil to the same pan. Spread it. I have these boiled eggs with me. I have cut it into half. In this way, I'm going to add it. I'm going to roast it from both the sides. You can add some more oil. I'm now going to add some oil on the top. Spread it over. Going to sprinkle some salt. Some turmeric powder. Red chili powder. I'm going to now flip them. Once flipped, I'm going to add some salt on this side as well. Turmeric powder. Red chili powder. So once these eggs are roasted from both the sides, I'm going to remove them. Just ensure that they do not stick to the bottom. So let's see the other side. So once they get a slightly golden crust from both the sides, I'm going to remove them from the pan. Let's put off the gas. I have heated some oil in the same pan, adding ginger garlic paste. Some dried curry leaves. Going to just stir them with hand. Adding some asafoetida. Going to add some water. Let the ginger garlic paste cook. You have seen the amount of oil that I use in my recipes. I try to make my recipes with the least amount of oil possible. So if you want to cook this ginger and garlic paste in the very minimum oil, adding water is a very good way to help it cook. I'm going to add some chopped onions. This is raw mango or amchur powder. Let the onions turn soft. So once the onions cook and turn soft, I'm going to add this mixture that we blended. I've added some water to this mixture jar. So this is around one bowl of water. I'm adding it. Now it depends how thick you want your gravy to be. After mixing, I'm going to add sugar, salt as per taste, I'm going to now cover it and let it simmer for some time. Let the gas be on a medium flame. So after 3 to 4 minutes, you can see the gravy has already started simmering. I'm going to now reduce the flame. Adding some dried coriander leaves. So what I do is, during summers, I dry these coriander leaves under the sun and store it so that you can use it whenever you want. Mixing it. Now the thickness of the gravy is as per your like. I have kept this thickness. So you can eat it with roti or naan, and it will also go with steamed rice. I'm going to now place the eggs. So once the eggs are placed, let it be on a very low flame for just 2 minutes and then I'm going to put off the gas. So after 2 minutes, I'm going to put off the gas. I'm going to serve it just like that. I'm garnishing it with the green chilies that we roasted. So this is ready to be served. Anda masala is ready to be served. Do let me know in the comment box how you like the recipe. See you soon with a new recipe. Till then, bye bye.